Welcome to Trigger Point Pilates with yoga. Today you will need your foam roller and two prickle balls. And then, should you have a little inversion stool, or if you feel comfortable doing a headstand by yourself or up against the wall, you'll have that opportunity towards the end of our yoga practice together. Don't worry. If that doesn't feel good for you, you can always do legs up a wall pose instead, which will give you the same kind of sensation. All right, my loves. So today we're going to take our time, really focus on the breathing, just resting, recuperating, no rush, no hurries, some TLC for you. All right, so let's start with the foam roller. And don't forget, if you need a little towel for underneath your head or a small soft cushion, you can use that too. Come and lie down with the roller behind you lengthways so that you're supported from your head to your sacrum. Bend your knees. Rest your arms somewhere down in a low V. Take your time here, just kind of get yourself organized, yeah? Have a wiggle around. Maybe sway a little bit from side to side. And then reach your arms up towards the ceiling. Start with small circles with your shoulders. And really allow your scapula, your shoulder blades to move freely, yes? You're going to feel them work around that compression. Tune into your breathing now. So breathing in through your nose and out through your nose. And you're in charge. So you can make those circles as small or as large as you want to. I'm now making my circles really big. Don't worry, I'm here to be your guide, so feel free to close your eyes. I'll be as descriptive as I can, that you don't have to strain to look at the video. You can just listen to my voice. Take your circles the other way. Really nice way just to realign, readjust, reset everything in your back before your gentle yoga practice today. Do one more circle wherever you are. And rest your arms down by your side. Feel free to wiggle around on your roller. Readjust if you'd like to. Exhale, go ahead and lift your left leg up. Keep it bent with your foot above the line of your knee. Hold on if you can behind your thigh with your left hand and draw that leg closer. Now feel your back move. Feel it lengthen. So you're growing. You have this, having the foam roller here really helps to lengthen your body. You feel your chin pull to your chest. Just one more breath. Go ahead and let go of that leg, lower your foot, and then slide that left foot all the way along the floor till your leg is straight. Maybe reach your opposite arm, your right arm up and overhead. Flex your left foot, drop your rib cage down, drop your abs too. Big stretch, breathe in. And exhale, bring your arm back down, pull your foot back in. Exhale, lift your right leg up. Bend, hold on behind your thigh, pull that leg towards you, let your back move. Don't worry if you're wobbling around on your foam roller, it's perfectly normal, it's a good sign. You're loosening up the fascia, creating movement, getting rid of any stiffness or rigidity. Another breath. Let go of your leg, lower your foot to the floor, and then slide it long till your right leg is straight. Reach your left arm overhead, flex your right foot, drop your rib cage down. Feel your abs contract.
And then pull everything back in. Good. Walk your feet in a little bit closer to you. Press your heels down into the ground. Let your toes fan up. Tilt your pelvis. Squeeze your seat. If it feels okay, you could lift your hips up off the roller or keep them down and just hold on to that pelvic tilt. And then wherever you are, just release down very slowly. If you're in a mini bridge, lower down one vertebrae at a time. And when your back is completely on the roller, let everything just melt and release. Do that again. Exhale, tilt your pelvis, press your heels down, squeeze your seat, lift up as high as you want to, and then pretend you've got a ball between your mid-thighs. So pull your inner legs towards one another. So deepen the stretch in the frontal fascial lines of your body, and then lower down smoothly. Release at the bottom. So yummy, doesn't it? Do that again. Push your heels, tilt, squeeze, lift, squeeze your imaginary ball that's between your inner thighs. And lower down smoothly. Surrender at the bottom. Reset your feet if you need to. Reach your left arm straight out to the left, out to the side. Let your gaze follow your fingers. Breathe in. And as you exhale, take that arm over your chest. Let your head follow your hand. Your back will sway on the roller. Your right hand's down on the floor. That's your balance. Breathe in. Open out to the left again, straight out to the side. This time as you exhale, draw your arm over your face. Breathe in. Open directly to the side. And this time, exhale, sweep your arm across your body, up and over your head. Let your shoulder blades move. Draw your arm back down by your side. Good. Other arm straight up to the right. Breathe in. Exhale, take that arm across your body. Breathe in, open to the right. Exhale, take your arm over your face. Breathe in, open out to the right. And exhale, sweep your arm across, up and over your head, and down it goes. Maybe open your feet a little wider and sway from side to side. If you feel like you have your balance and you want to, reach your arms up towards the ceiling. As your knees go to the right, your arms and your gaze can come to the left. And then switch it. And move slowly with your breath. Be very conscious, very mindful of your breathing. Your hands down very carefully, roll off your roller, and you can put it to one side. If you'd like to have a drink, go ahead and have one. Cheers. And then find your prickle balls. Okay, now sit down and place your balls underneath your glutes, right in that beautiful muscly part of your gluteus maximus. Keep your knees bent. Your hands can come behind you like kickstands. And gentle massage forward and back just to loosen up. All around your glutes, your pelvis, your lumbar spine, and use your hamstrings too. I always say your pelvis is your central station, yeah? Everything stems off from there. So if we can keep your sacrum, your pelvis nice and open, it will help you get through your day, whatever you're doing. Never mind if it's yoga or working or
walking, sitting, anything. Got to keep that pelvis nice and healthy. And then sit up so that your balls will come right at the base of your glutes and the top of your thighs. And bend your legs and just allow your knees to open to the side. Now, if you're a little tender and that doesn't feel comfortable to sit on the balls like this, then you can always place a towel over the top of them and that will just soften it up a little bit should you need it. Good, and sit up nice and tall, breathing in. And exhale, if it's comfortable for you, start to walk your hands forward. And take your time here, there's no rush. Don't feel that you have to fold all the way over your legs. Listen to your body. Take your time. Nice, steady breathing. There's a beautiful breeze. Relax your neck, allow your head just to bow. One more deep breath. And then slowly, slowly take your time, walk your hands back. So you can come to an upright position. And then it's your choice, my lovelies, opening your legs to a wide straddle. If you have low back sensitivity, keep your balls underneath your glutes. If you feel that your hamstrings are a little bit tight, then feel free to take the balls away and place them, see your knee crease, just above there. Right at the base of your hamstrings. And it's up to you. You can point your feet, you can flex your feet, you can do a little bit of both. Your legs do not have to be straight. You can keep a soft bend in them. Again, sitting up tall, breathe in. And then exhale. If it feels comfortable to walk your hands forward, go for it. Take your time here. And if you need to readjust those balls, feel free to do that. Sometimes you've got to wiggle them around to get them in the right spot. Worry if your back is not straight and long. What about relaxing today? Just resting into the postures. Very slowly walking your hands up. Take the balls away. Give them a little shake. Good. Place your balls to one side. And just sit comfortably somewhere. Feel free to sit on a pillow or a bolster. That feels more comfortable for you. Some of you might be comfortable in a lotus position, or you can sit cross-legged, or in a modified square pose like me, with one foot in front of the other. And just rest your hands somewhere on your legs and close your eyes. Take a deep breath in through your nose, really fill up. do that again. Deep breath in. Exhale, sigh it out. Just breathing naturally again, breathing in through your nose, out through your nose. Now you can keep your eyes closed or you can open them, just have a soft gaze, and let's create some movement in your spine. So as you breathe in, press your chest forward. And as you exhale, take your ribcage to the side and then pull back and then to the other side. So making nice little circular movements with your breath. Nice and slow, nice and steady. Allow your hips to kind of rock side to side as you adjust in your circles. Really explore here, yeah? Feel. What's going on in your body? Now, maybe this feels tricky already, so avoid any judgment. Just be aware of what's going on. And then take your circles the other way. If you're in a square pose or got your legs crossed or lotus, then switch them. Just for funsies, right? So we say even Stevens. That can feel a little strange when you do that because it's not your dominant side. Again, just be aware of how it feels. Making yourself comfortable within your own skin. Maybe you find you're sitting up a little bit taller now. Perhaps you're feeling that the breathing is coming more naturally to you. It's not such a conscious effort to breathe so steadily and with such awareness. Come and meet me in a child's pose. Bring your toes together. Have some space between your legs. How much is up to you. If you would like a little cushion to put on the floor in front of you, feel free to do that. That makes you feel more comfortable. You can also place a cushion between your shins and your hamstrings. That will relieve some tension on stiff or sore knees. And go ahead and walk your hands forward. Bring your forehead down to your yoga mat. And really push down right in the middle of your forehead. Pull your shoulders down your back. So feel like you're pulling on your yoga mat with the palms of your hands. Yeah, you've got some traction there. Maybe make a little crease between your eyebrows with that pressure of your third eye on the ground. And feel free just to swing your hips a little bit from side to side as you ease into this posture. It should feel pretty nice to do that, seeing as you have given yourself a nice little massage before your yoga practice. And go ahead and walk your hands over to the left hand side. And maybe bring your right hand on top of your left. And again, pull your shoulders actively down your back. Feel a little stretch down the right side of your body. And then go ahead and carefully walk your hands through center. Take them over to the right hand side. Overlap your left hand on your right. Feel a deeper stretch on the left side of your shoulder, your obliques, your waist. Wonderful. And then coming back to center again. Come and meet me on all fours. Place your your hands under your shoulders. Keep your legs hips width apart with your feet lining up behind your knees. And play with it today. Maybe you want to turn your hands out slightly, or maybe you would like to turn them in a little bit. See what feels good on your wrists. And start to make little circular movements, just so you can warm up your hands, your wrist joints, keeping some fluid motion in your back and in your hips. And take your circles the other way. Bring yourself to be still and turn your right fingers back. Now, they may just turn out to the side a little bit, but if you can turn them around so your fingers are facing towards you, fantastic. And again, little circles here, continuing to warm up the forearms, the wrists, the hands. Bring your hands to face forward, or your left hand to face forward, I should say, and then repeat with the right hand. So turn it out a little bit or more. Remember, there's no competition in yoga, yes? You just do what feels right for you, what feels good for your body. Every day is different. Each side of your body feels different too. Under. Now really press down with your toes and start to pull your belly button up towards your spine. So you feel a bit of a contraction there. Think long through your neck. So like somebody's got the hairs on the top of your head and they're pulling you directly forward. So you've got lots of space all down your vertebrae. Spread your fingers out wide and then just lift your knees up off the floor. Hold it there. Chin is slightly up, so you're going to start to feel some heat, some warmth in your lower quads. Maybe shift your weight back a little bit. You'll feel it in your abs, in your upper back, your shoulders. Really press down with your fingertips as well as the palms of your hands. Maybe claw your fingers a little bit. If you're starting to shake, smile, embrace it. Starting to get some blood flow going around. Your heart rate is starting to pump. It's good for you. Take another breath here. And exhale, slowly lower your knees down. Keep your feet flexed. You can always bring your legs and feet in a little bit closer. Come and sit back on your heels. Now you can sit back on them, you can stay up. Whatever feels right for your knees. And just clasp your hands in front of you. So bring them together and do little circular motions, just working out those wrists. One way and the other way. Good, and then give them a little shake out. Gorgeous. To all fours, spread your fingers out wide. You ready for your first downward dog? Maybe take your feet and your knees back out to hips width apart if you came in closer like I did. And press against the floor with your hands, with your toes, lift your hips up, up we come. Now nice and gentle to start off with. So bend one knee, then the other knee. Keep doing that, yeah? At your own pace, really feeling out, push your hips up towards the ceiling. Yeah, so avoid dumping too much weight in your hands.
think about lifting up with your hips and with your tailbone. Use your feet here too. Good. And pull your shoulders actively down your back. Think about opening your triceps out and away from each other. So you get a bit of a rotation in your arms. Do you feel that? You feel your upper back muscles opening up as well. Bend your elbows, breathe in. And exhale, straighten your arms. Good. Alright, go ahead and lift your right leg up towards the sky. Bend it. And then really open up that hip. So it feels like you're stacking your right hip above your left. And then intentionally press your upper body so that you're very equal with your hands on the floor and your shoulders are level. Good. Keep breathing. Straighten your leg again. Breathe in. And then as you exhale, draw your knee to your chest, pull your belly button up. You're bringing your foot forward between your hands. Place your left knee down. Keep your toes curled under. With your hands on the floor, lift your chest. Of course, if you wanted your yoga blocks to put your hands on, you can do that too. And just feel that lengthening down your left hip flexor and your thigh. Be sure that your right ankle is directly underneath your right knee. Adjust if you need to. This may be enough, but if you feel you'd like to, for a deeper stretch, you come up. Bring your hands to your heart center. Always coming back to your breath. Carefully lower your chin to your chest. Feel that stretch up the back. Your neck, your cervical spine, and bring your head back up to center, and then gently gaze up. So if we're throwing your head back, just a lift of your eyes towards the sky. Bring your head back to center, place your hands on the floor, go ahead and lift your back knee off the ground, keep your weight over your front leg. Place your left hand down, right next to the inside of your right foot, and a gentle twist. Reach your right arm up towards the ceiling. Open up your chest. So avoid letting your head dangle. Think long. Yes, so be still with the hairs on your head, and then pulling you up and forward. Reaching up with your right fingertips. Give them a little wiggle. Lots of energy there. Breathe in. Exhale. Maybe rotate more. And then bring your hand back down to the ground. Lower your knee. You're shifting back, aiming to straighten your front leg in a hamstring stretch. Now you can keep those back toes tucked under. You could untuck your foot if you wish. And then everybody bend your right knee. Yeah. Maybe a little sway from side to side. You know I love lots of movement in yoga. And then if it feels comfortable, straighten that leg again. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, maybe reach deeper. Just know reaching deeper for you may be up here with your hands on your thigh. That's absolutely fine. One more breath. And exhale. Beautiful. Shift your weight forward. Coming back into that lunge position, curl your back toes under, place your hands down on the ground, you're stepping back to a plank position, push down firmly here, squeeze your seat, pull your navel up, feel very solid and strong, and then lift your hips up high, downward facing dog. Good, pull your shoulders down your back, rotate your triceps out and away, and then lift your left leg up, big breath in. And then bend that knee and stack your left hip over your right. Square off your ribcage, your shoulders. Feel that openness in your hips. And you're reaching that right heel towards the floor. So you feel
between your hands. Place your right knee down. Keep your toes curled under and lift your chest. Gaze forward. Feel how this side is reacting. Maybe creep your front foot forward or back just so that your knee is aligned beautifully over your ankle. You may want to come up a little higher. Bring your hands to your heart center if you do. Lower your chin to your chest. Bring your head through center. Lift your gaze slightly. Bring your head to center. Bring your hands to the floor. Lift your back knee up. Place your right hand down. Reach your left arm up. Lots of lift, yes? Even though you're rotating, avoid crunching and crushing. Really think long and open. And every time you exhale, open a little bit more. These twists are so good for your body. You're giving your innards a big hug. And then when you release the twist, all that blood flows to all those important parts of your body, your muscles, your organs. And then bring that hand down, lower your back knee to the floor, shifting back, straightening your front leg, flex your front foot for your half split. Bend your front knee a lot. Yeah. Little sway, small wiggle, feel it. And then straighten your front leg, inhale, lengthen. And exhale, explore deeper into that stretch. Breathe in, lift a little bit. Exhale, relax more. Place your hands down, coming back to your plank position. Squeeze, feel strong, feel powerful, feel proud of yourself. Lift your hips high, downward facing dog. Try and hold it steady here. Just get into that beautiful form. Nice long neck. Maybe shake out your head, yes and no. Do you feel longer in your back? Let's move through that sequence again, faster this time with the breath. So breathe in, reach your right leg up. Exhale, pull that knee forwards, step between your hands. Lower your back knee, inhale, lengthen. Lift up, reach both arms up this time. Exhale, bring your hands down to the floor. Lift your back knee up, big breath in for your twist. And exhale, bring your hand down, lower your knee, and you're shifting back into your half split. Stay here. Breathe in, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Breathe in, shift forward. Exhale, taking it back to plank and downward facing dog. Left leg, breathe in, lift. Exhale, pull through and step. Knee goes down. Inhale, raise both arms up. Celebrate. Exhale, bring your hands down. Lift your back knee up. Raise your left arm. Twist, breathe in. Exhale, lower your hand back down, your knee as well, shift back to your half split, hold it here. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, relax more. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Exhale, plank, downward facing dog.
your toes together, child's pose. Reach your arms forward. And if you'd like some release for your shoulders, your neck, sweep your arms down by your side. Just rest them there. Let everything relax. Yes, and press down with your third eye right in the center of your forehead. Make that little crease between your eyebrows. Feel your back opening, expanding as you breathe in, and then feel it decrease in size as you exhale so you can sink lower into the posture. One more breath. Carefully coming up to your knees. And now, my lovelies, it's your choice. You can either join me in a headstand. Some of you may be comfortable doing a headstand all by yourself. Send me photos. I'm still waiting for the photos, guys. Haven't seen any pictures of you doing your stuff yet. And if you have an inversion stool like I have, you can use that. You could do your headstand up against the wall, and if you don't want to do a headstand today, that's perfectly fine. You have other options. You can find yourself a wall, snuggle up close to it, and place your legs up the wall. If you'd like to do waterfall, you can take a yoga block and place it underneath your sacrum and lift your legs up. So you've got options, my lovelies. All right? So choose whatever you're doing. Headstands, legs up the wall pose, also very good for you, very restorative, it's wonderful for your lymphatic system, it really helps to balance your hormones, it releases stress, it's great for your cardiovascular system. How else can I sell it to you? Alright, so you don't have to stay here very long if you're in a headstand, you can stay there as long as you want to. Your legs up the wall pose. Alright? So wherever you are, this is your time to explore. Okay?
gently come out of whatever posture you're doing. Come and join me. Make sure that you have room now to lie down. Find your prickle balls. Lie down. We will rest in a reclining cobbler pose. So if this is a little uncomfortable for your hips, feel free to get a couple of cushions that you can put underneath your knees for support. Lie down and place your balls either at your glutes or your sacrum. Bring your feet together and allow your knees just to open. Relax your arms by your side. Take a deep breath in. Adjust the balls, like I want to take mine out a little bit wider, feels good in my low back too. And your feet can be in closer towards your groin or further away. Play with it, see what feels nice. Bring your right hand to your tummy, your left hand to your heart center, and breathe into your hands. Feel your tummy expand, your chest as you inhale, and as you exhale, you feel all that air exit your body. Release your hands. Go ahead and place your feet on the floor a little wider than your hips. Keep your knees bent. And then gentle windshield wipers from side to side. And maybe you want to bring the balls up higher. I'm going to place them right behind my sacrum now. Just because I feel that my low back needs that love. And I like to do small figures of eight with my hips. Myself a yummy massage. So play with it, friends. See what feels nice for you today. Bring your hips to center. Take the balls away. Reach your legs long, stretch your arms up overhead, big breath in, stretch, 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 and exhale, release it. And just resting now into Shavasana, open your legs to a comfortable width, give them a shake, relax your bum, relax your tummy, give your shoulders a wiggle, your rib cage, pick your head up, maybe take your head from side to side till you feel that nice, relaxed central position. Relax your teeth, keep them open behind your lips. And now just breathe naturally at your own pace. No need to keep your breaths equal, just nice and comfy.
fingers and your toes. Start to bring some awareness back to the body. Maybe have a stretch again. Very slowly rolling over to one side. Take your time, there's no rush. Keep your eyes closed. Sit in a comfortable position. Oh, I hope you guys feel as tall as I do. I feel nice and light. Hopefully you do the same. Roll your shoulders forward, up, back and down. Bring your hands to your heart center. Press your thumbs right to the inner part of your breastbone. Love from me to you. Promise yourself lots of love and patience and compassion. And then bring your palms up towards your forehead. Press your thumbs right between your eyebrows. A little pressure there. With an open mind as well as an open heart. Week be full of clarity, great knowledge, lots of love and kindness, and namaste. Thank you for practicing with me today. I hope that you feel good.